there's a huge hype and vibe around the first, you know, sort of few months leading up into this period of not only San Remo but the classics as well coming up after. So it's just a, you know, a huge tradition, history behind the race. For me personally, it's a dream race. It's a, I think, a race that really suits me personally as a professional cyclist, you know, characteristically. So something that I've always dreamt about, you know, doing well. Done well a couple of times here in the past, so hopefully can do well again tomorrow for my teams, for myself and for my team Astana. You know, it's not a process that happens overnight. You know, you need to have a nice solid base foundation under your belt, you know, coming into this sort of race. There's no shortcuts, you know, 300 kilometres like you say. So it's a race of, you know, your attrition. You need to look after yourself, you need to be in good condition physically. You know, there's no hiding, you know, there's no excuses either. You know, tomorrow it's all or nothing. You put it all on the table for a race like tomorrow, you know, you take the risk because it's worth it. You know, I try and look after myself throughout the whole race, eating and drinking wise. As well, I try and look after my cadence and, you know, just try and get through the races energy saving as possible. You know, bikes are a part of that as well. You know, I specialise right on top of you know, technological side of things in the cycling world these days, and you know, it's nice to have a specialised bike. You know, being, for me personally, being so light and responsive and stiff, it's perfect for a race like San Remo. You know, you can get through the race with the confidence. You got the highest bike under yourself, and you know, it's a nice additive, nice confidence boost, so to speak, coming into the race, because it's something that's very important.
Hey, ciao.